This is a clip from the Canon podcast. To hear the full episode and get access to exclusive benefits, head over to patreon.com/thecannonpod and sign up for just £3 a month.
But now let's talk about Mikel Arteta's inverted flip. We're going to start off with Alex. What have you made of Arsenal's Mikel Arteta's brand new, you know, system innovation?
Yeah, it's exciting. And it's something that I was interested to see whether we'd buy. Essentially, how we approach the market would tell me what we're going to do with that inversion and whether we carry it on. I couldn't imagine that it would just be a left-sided thing that he wanted to do. I always felt as though we'd move on to the right-hand side, but also, you know, it could be that the left-hand side was the thing that changed, whether it was, you know, a Tierney-type profile, I'm not saying Kieran Tierney, and a Zinchenko-type profile was always the interchange on the left-hand side. But to me, it makes more sense to be able to choose essentially which side you want the inversion, whether you want it on the right or the left. I like it. I think Thomas Partey isn't the ceiling in that position. I think there's he struggles defending wide spaces. He got caught really flat against Hwang-hee-chan in the first couple of minutes against Wolves. And you can see he's just on his toes back, and you can see he's just not a natural wide space defender. Perhaps I shouldn't mention him till later, but I think there's a reason we're chasing Moises Caicedo, because I think he's the perfect someone who can come in. And again, it's like people say, oh, you're going to play him at right back. No, he's going to be out of possession in the right back position, and he'll come inside into the two or the 2-3 or whatever it ends up being. So I think it's useful. I mean, realistically, what we need as a general, and George can possibly speak more to the kind of the its benefits moving forward, but from a build-up perspective, we need different ways of approaching different things. Some teams high press you in a 3-2-1. Some teams come at you in a low 3. Some teams come at you in a 2. You need different ways of finding the spare man, basically. And it's also a case of being able to tactically, within a game, be able to like, okay, we started off in a 2-3. They're pressing us. They're coming man for man. They've managed to cut off the entry lanes. We're getting pushed down the sides. Right, let's switch into a 2-3. Do we get more options ahead of the ball in that case? Can we go to a 2-4? Does Caicedo go out to the right hand side? It's this variability that we need to have, and this ability to break teams down in different ways. And one of the reasons I'm worried about Xhaka going is the coach on the pitch thing. And I hope that we have enough people on the pitch, whether it's Ødegaard, whether it's I don't know, you know, someone else. I'm struggling, to be honest.
Gabriel.
Well, I was going to say Gabriel, but I haven't necessarily seen that. I think he has potential to do that. To be the guy who's like, you know, if you watch Jorginho against Nottingham Forest, he's going, no, Kivior, move. You need to be here. We need those guys. So yeah, I think it's interesting. It's a natural evolution. And I think in certain games, I think it will be useful. I'll be interested to see if we stick with Zinchenko more generally, because he's a very unique profile, and he's very good at that. That's kind of, you know, he's the progression he offers from that position. When we're in the ascendancy against teams, his counter press and his early stepping in is unbelievable. And he was so good at it for City as well. So I wonder whether we like generally skew to the left and it becomes an option, or it's a complete, you know, one game on, one game off. I don't know. But yeah, that's my thoughts on it.
The build up against Wolves is very fluid. You know, some of the football we were playing was fantastic. And, you know, you have the three, of course, centre-backs of Kivior, Ben White and Gabriel. And we have seen Pep Guardiola have that, you know, full centre-back back four, and that worked for him very well. And of course, in terms of the build-up phase, you look at, of course, Roberto De Zerbi's Brighton, and they are very, very fluid. It seems like Mikel Arteta is trying to take it to the next level to make sure that this year, what we saw towards the end of this season, that lack of reliability isn't there next year. George, what do you make of this tactical innovation?
Well, I think, look, I keep fighting on Twitter where I first suggested this at Palace.
Are you fighting on Twitter?
Yeah, well, a little bit. You know, some people, not just Alex, but I mean, a lot of people, I kept saying to people, this system isn't different. We need, as fans, to get out of this FIFA mentality of saying the left back must invert, and that's the only way that what we see happens. And when you really look at it, by the way, the system fundamentals are this. One fullback will invert, and on the same side as that fullback that inverts, the winger is more of a touchline winger. That is a consistent thing that we see. When it's on the left, you see Zinchenko and Martinelli. When it was on the right with Partey, Jesus was the one that was feeling was much more of a touchline winger, and really Saka came inside quite a bit more. Now, when you have that switch, that means that kind of your central midfielder, okay, he is somebody that is going to maybe be the one that is forcefully trying to put the winger inside or remain a little bit deeper. Those are some of the fundamentals that you're going to see on the same side. Now, the opposite side, when you see a fullback that is going to be a little bit more willing to go ahead and provide the dynamic overlap. This year, it was Ben White. But as we saw with the system kind of on against Wolves, it was a little bit more of Kiwior's responsibility to push up. And in fact, I think if you go back and you watch Jorginho, he's telling Kiwior, get wide, get out of here because I need my space. And so when you look at kind of what is the difference here, I think, again, I would go back to the Adrian Clark breakdown that he does today. And Zinchenko mentions it, guys. I love the part where he talks about the buildup and he mentions it specifically where the structure needs to be fluid in order to exploit the spaces that are left by the opposition. It's not a rigid formation. Zinchenko makes a point by saying, I don't just invert for the sake of inverting. I go when the space is there. Otherwise, I will stay wide and have somebody else come to fill in that spot. And that is the crux of positional play. I think fans talk about positional play and don't quite understand it because they still apply these rigid FIFA structures to it. It's not the case. So when you have a team that's tactically able to do this, we need to understand that the roles of these systems are going to maintain similar principles, but the way that some of these players will do it will just be slightly different. Like if we were to do a Moises Caicedo in a kind of Partey analog, what we saw against Wolves, that's not changing the system that we've done all season. We've actually done the exact same system. One thing that I would implore a lot of people is, does Rice and Caicedo let you attack with six players? Question mark. Potentially. You've got a huge rest defense there that maybe allows a more offensive fullback like a Ben White to really add with these two, because you've got two monsters that will control transitions. That, for me, would be a system change, and that's something that I'll look towards in preseason. By the way, we had instances where we did attack with six this season, and it was kind of hinted at quite a bit in preseason, and it would be something that if I was trying to do my little prediction hat right now, we're going to see a lot more of a six-channel attack next season if we recruit a Rice and Caicedo. That would be something that I would look for as a change in system. But just as fans, let's get comfortable with the fact that, you know, not one way of playing is good, despite it producing great football, okay? And the entire football that we talked about, it wasn't because we just had one way of playing. We have done a build-up that has been different in so many different games within the same game. Against Liverpool, I counted three different times that we had a different build-up on its own. So we just got to get comfortable with doing that, and we're buying players that are Swiss Army knives, guys. They're not going to be specific players. You know, they're going to be performing multiple roles in-game. And I think that's good. That's just tactically flexible and that's smart.
What would this mean for Ben White, though? Because, of course, Arsenal are targeting maybe a midfielder that can play on this inverted right-back side. If we do sign that profile and you spend upwards of, what, 60, 70, 80 million pounds, surely he starts straight away if it's not in that role. What's Ben White's best position in his team, Alex? Do you think it's a centre-back to maybe back up Saliba or maybe start some games there, or is it still as that right-back?
Thanks for checking out the Cannon Podcast. To get full episodes and access to exclusive benefits, head over to patreon.com/thecannonpod and sign up for just £3 a month.